एम ज्योति, a lecturer in Chemical Engineering Department, SJ Government Polytechnic. In this session of particulate technology lab, we will learn about the screen effectiveness. So you already know in the last session of screen analysis, what is exactly the screen analysis, what is screen and what is screening. The screen is being used to separate the particles according to their size alone. Okay, the particles which has to be separated according to their size is being put in a set of screens and it is being saved for 10 to 20 minutes. And whatever the particles which are being collected on each surface of the screen is being collected and it is weighed. So in this experiment, which is called the screen effectiveness, the aim of this experiment is to find out the effectiveness of the screen, effectiveness of the given screen. Any screen could be given, any screen in the sense it may be a number of 8 or of 16 according to the mesh size. Any screen could be given to find the effectiveness of the screen. So effectiveness of the screen will depend upon the shape of the bed and also the condition of the screen and the screening operation. So it depends upon the shape of the bed, what shape it is, and the condition, what condition the screen is, and the time of screening, which is given, or the screening operation. So what effectiveness is exactly? So effectiveness of the screen is defined as how far the screen is effective in the recovery of the design material, how far the screen is effective in recovery of the desired material in the product, and also rejection of the undersized material from the product. So that is what we call it as effectiveness of the screen. The screen effectiveness is also depend upon what the quantity of the feed which you are feeding to the set of screens, and also the time of the screening operation. So these are the factors which have influenced the effectiveness of the screen. So the apparatus required for this experiment is the feed material or the sample material, about 300 grams, and the set of the screens which have been arranged according to their size. The number, the smallest number will be at the top, and the largest number will be at the bottom. Below that you have a pad. So according to their size and the number, it is being arranged in a stack, and the material which has to be, the sample which you have taken is put onto the screen. Then the lid is being closed. So the shaking is being done either manually or mechanically. So manually in the sense, we have to hold like this and we have to shake it for 10 minutes. So mechanically you can do the sieve shaker you have in your lab. If you have in your lab, you can do it in the sieve shaker for about 10 to 15 minutes. So after shaking for 10 to 15 minutes, whatever is retained on each screen is being taken and it is being weighed in a weighing balance. Then whatever is being retained on each screen is being taken and it is being weighed on a weighing balance. So after doing that, the screen whose efficiency which you have to find out is being taken, and about 300 grams again it is being put on the screen and it is being shaken along with a pad. For example, if you have taken 300 grams, think that you have taken 300 grams in the screen, screen number 8, whose effectiveness you have to find out. So 300 grams is being put onto this screen and again along with the pan, and it is being shaken for 10 to 15 minutes. After shaking of 10 to 15 minutes, whatever is retained on on the top of the screen will be taken as oversized material, and what is being passed through this screen will be taken as a, which is being retained on the pan will be taken as a undersized material. So the whatever is being retained as an oversized material is again sieved through a set of screens. By arranging the screens again, it is being sieved through a set of screens. The oversized material which is being retained on this particular screen, it is again being shaken for 10 minutes, and what is retained on the respective screens will be weighed in a weighing balance, and whatever the material which is being the particular screen number 8 which is as an undersized particle which you have taken, that is also again it is being sieved through a set of screens arranged according to their number and the size. So then the values, the weight retained on each screen for the feed material, you have to tabulate the values after taking the weights of the oversized material, the undersized material and the feed material. So this is how the tabular column looks like. So the mesh number you have to write, then the screen aperture will be given for you. Then the feed material weight retained on each screen you have to tabulate. Then you have to find out the weight fraction, which will be denoted at D5. Then the cumulative weight fraction, you have to find out. Cumulative fraction is the weight fraction of the first one with the added to the weight fraction of the second one. That will give you the weight cumulative weight fraction. Similarly, you have to find out for the oversized material and also for the undersized material which has been screened in a particular screen whose effectiveness has to be found out. So this is how you tabulate your data and calculate the data in the tabular column. So the effectiveness is nothing but recovery into the product of recovery into rejection into 100. So this is how, and you have a formula to find out the effectiveness of the screen. So the formula is given by E is equal to XF minus XB into XB minus XF into XT into 1 minus XB, the whole divided by XT minus XB whole square into 1 minus XF into XF. So XF, XB and XT values you will get it from the graph. The graph you have to plot is the cumulative mass fraction of the feed, the cumulative mass fraction of the feed, oversized and the undersized particle which you have calculated. So the of versus the average particle diameter you have to plot. The cumulative weight fraction of feed, the oversized and undersized particle versus the diameter of the particle is being plotted, and this is how you get the nature of the graph. From the graph you will get XF mass fraction of the feed material, XB mass fraction of the undersized material and XT mass fraction of the oversized material. So you have got the from the graph XF, XB and XT values. So these values are being put in this formula in order to find out the effectiveness of this given screen. By using this formula you can find out the effectiveness of the given screen. This is the result. You have to find out by the experiment called the screen effectiveness. Thank you.